Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It's Thursday, the 30th of November. The Royal Commission of Inquiry into Bank Negara's forex losses released its report today, revealing losses amounting to 31.5 billion ringgit in foreign exchange trading between 1992 and 1994. At the centre of all this, the RCI named the then person in charge of forex transactions in Bank Negara, Nor Mohamed Yakcop. However, they also named the then Bank Negara governor, the late Jaafar Hussein, his deputy Lin See Yan, the Bank Negara board of directors, then Finance Minister Anwar Ibrahim, and the then Prime Minister Dr. Mahathir Mohamad as those who share some responsibility in the incident. Now that the report has been done and compiled, Penang Chief Minister Lim Guaning expressed his shock on the matter, as the figure in this latest report is 21 billion ringgit higher than the one reported at the time.
Now, where was that hidden? And how come it was hidden so cleverly that no one detected it until the RCI reviewed this? I think our accountants, when you talk about creative accounting, even all these Enron, all these Lehman Brothers, all must learn from Malaysia, because they was never detected.
In response to the Sarawak Chief Minister Abang Johari Openg disputing Dewan Rakyat Speaker Pandikar Amin Mulia's opinion about the Malaysia Agreement 1963, Pandikar today welcomed the idea of debating with him on the matter.
I'm used to listening to all this, including the ministers. So it doesn't make any difference to me what is the opinion of the Chief Minister of Sarawak.
You want to debate with him?
Oh yes, if you want to debate with me, most welcome. Not only Nasru, but if it is the Chief Minister of Sarawak, anytime.
Kinabatang MP Bung Mokhtar Radin told billionaire Robert Kwok to stop making unfair remarks about Malaysian leaders and instead to share his wealth by investing in the country instead. In his latest memoir, Robert Kwok noted that Malaysia's leaders chose a racially skewed way of doing business after May 13, 1969. However, Bung said that the government had to take a racial approach in order to help the Malay community and insist that Malaysia is on the right track. Bung also said that Kwok has an obligation to return to Malaysia and help with the country's development since he has strayed out. The number of flood victims in Kelantan has risen to 13,539 as of 9 a.m. today, compared to 12,734 flood victims as of last night. The number is the tally of flood victims put up at 100 relief centres across 9 districts in the state. According to the Welfare Department's Info Banjir application, the district of Pasir Mas recorded the highest number of victims. The water levels of Sungai Golok at Pasir Mas and Kuala Jambu are both above their danger levels, and the water continued to rise overnight. And that's it for me today. For more, go on over to KiniTV.com. Please do subscribe and share this video. I'm Daniel Anthony. Thank you for watching.